Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Survival Heights Season 2, my amplified hardcore single player survival world. And today, as I do every year, is a very special episode because today we're going over our resolutions. So, format for today, we're going to go over our resolutions slash goals from 2023, and then we're going to go over our new goals for the channel and otherwise for 2024. So, without further ado, let's get started. Oh, and before I go any further, hopefully you guys enjoyed the world tour. I think the tour, the 3,000 day tour, went pretty well, and I think I showcased everything that I wanted to. So, yeah, hopefully another one at 3,500 days. But let's go over what our goals were for 2023. And actually, can I hop on some bricks here so we can get a better vantage point? All right, so what were our goals in 2023? I'm also going to go over what exactly we did in 2023 to achieve these goals, if we achieved any of them, which I was looking through this list a little bit earlier, and I don't think we achieved many. So let's start the first row. 12,000 subscribers on YouTube. Every year, I typically have a subscriber goal on YouTube. It's a numbers goal that you can't necessarily control, but I've historically always liked having that goal. And so that's why I had one last year. We did not hit 12,000 subscribers. We pretty much stagnated, which is because I pretty much didn't upload. So that kind of makes sense. 3,500 days in SHS2, which stands for Survival Heights Season 2. We hit 3,000 days. We did not hit 3,500 days. So I cannot check that one off. Upload at least 5 build tutorials, and build showcase videos. It's kind of the next stage of content that I want to branch out into because I think I have a lot of things that I can give to the Minecraft community in that regard. So did not do that this year. That will be a focus in the next year, which you'll see in just a minute. Middle row was typically reserved for Twitch streaming goals. I didn't really have many this year, so that's why there's only one, or there's only two stream goals on here. One of them was average two days per week streams. I don't think we hit an actual average of 2 days a week, but I'm fairly certain we got pretty close. So I'm going to check that off, even though I don't know the actual average. We were fairly consistent this year with streams, and so I think that went pretty well. Finish my website. For those of you guys who do not know, I have a website. I might put it on screen. I might not. Whitefire.com. Essentially, it lists all my videos and it also lists all my world downloads on there, things like that. And so, yeah, we did not finish that. Well, it is finished, quote unquote, but I have like a new update to the website that I want to publish and I just haven't gotten to it. So more to come with about that later. And then update all stream graphics. I did not do. I didn't do emotes or any of those kinds of things. And then onto the final row. These are typically more personal goals. So you'll see down here a Linux certification. That was for my work life section of myself. Did not do that. I ended up not really wanting to do it either as time went on. So no, did not do a certification in that. Get a dog. That is one of the pretty much the only goal that we fully completed this past year. Let you guys know from stream or otherwise, my dog Bailey, we got her in April. So yep, achieve that. Exercise every day. I did not achieve. I pretty much exercise once or twice a week right now. So definitely did not achieve that. All right, let's go to bed. But while I'm trying to find a bed, we've got our 2024 goals, and 2024 is going to be a little bit different. As I'm recording this, I haven't announced this quite yet. I took December off from streaming over on Twitch, and that is going to continue. So there won't be any stream goals this year. There will primarily be focused on YouTube and then some personal goals. So let's head down to our 2024 goals. So it took me a little bit to try to figure these out because this is the first year where I'm only really doing YouTube related goals and personal goals, and I don't really have other goals. So it took me a little bit to kind of come up with these, but let's start with the top row here. Actually, before I do that, just in case I die, or just in case a creeper blows up, not that I'm going to die. So first off, 52 long form YouTube videos. So this whole first row is definitely YouTube and this world focused. So what that means is there's 52 weeks in a year, right? One video per week for the whole year. I'm not expecting myself to actually have a video every single week. That's why I put a number to it. The 52 is the number because that's the number of weeks. That doesn't necessarily mean that every week's going to have a video because I'm definitely not going to be 100% consistent with that. I know that there are weeks where I'm going to accidentally skip or not have a video for whatever. And that means other weeks I might have to upload 2 or 3 videos to catch up on it. But It's been a long time since I've uploaded minimum 50 videos, and I really want to start doing that again because I really enjoy making content. I just don't put in the time and effort to do it. So that's our first goal. Second goal, same goal as this past year. We want to hit 3,500 days. I think this is going to be a pretty easy goal this year. That's why I'm putting this on here and not going to 4,000 days. So 3,500 days is the goal. And that's specifically for this world, right? So I think based upon last year's velocity in terms of how long it took us to get to 3,000 days, I think in the 3,500 days this year makes a lot of sense. And then the third goal on this row is 104 YouTube shorts. So some of you guys have probably noticed this. Some of you watching this may have come from some of the shorts that I've uploaded on this channel. But every time I upload a video, I tend to upload 2 to 3 YouTube shorts that are based off of that video. And that's just kind of make content in both avenues. I tend to think of shorts, at least in the context of this channel, as sort of highlights, funny bits, highlight bits from the long form content. And that's why I think 104 is 52 times 2. So basically averaging 2 a week or 2 per video, 2 shorts per long form YouTube video is what I'm going for there. Middle row, I went with not necessarily YouTube focused. I mean, one of them is YouTube focused, but more just general content things. I expanded into shorts a lot more frequently this past year. This upcoming year, I want to really focus on build tutorials. So I want to upload at least one build tutorial this year. Last year, if we go over here, last year I had 5. And seeing that number, I didn't even want to get started because 5 seemed like a lot. So just do one. Just upload one build tutorial. Could be, I could upload showcases or other kinds of build content alongside that, but at least when I have one tutorial up. Finish the website, same goal as last year. I want to actually finish the website update that I have. I'm essentially what I'm doing, for those of you who are more coding inclined and are curious, I coded the original website in HTML and CSS. I'm updating to a TypeScript React framework. So I know a lot of technical terms there for most people, but that's what I'm trying to do with that. And I started the update, I just haven't finished it. So I want to finish that this year. And then the third one is Instagram. So I've always loved uploading photos of screenshots of builds and whatnot over on Instagram. I just don't do it frequently. So upload 50 Instagram posts, or at least 50 Instagram posts, which are all typically different builds this year. I want to get back consistent with Instagram. I think it's a great platform to share my build content on. And now we are down to the personal goals. So the left one, run 3 times per week. This goes back to the exercise goal that I had last year. I want to get back to running 3 times, at least 3 times per week. If it's more than that, awesome. But I think 3 is where I'm going to get to. Would I love to go start lifting weights again? Absolutely. But I think this is a good starting place to get back in that rhythm. So 3 times per week is the goal. The second one here is kind of a professional goal to some degree. So for those of you who don't know, I'm a software engineer by trade. That's what I do for my day-to-day job. And I use a variety of programming languages historically. More recently, I use more, if you know what the C or C++ languages are, that's primarily what I use. I know some Python, I know some TypeScript, as I mentioned earlier, for my website. I want to learn one new programming language this year to add to my arsenal. I don't know what that language is yet. I have to go through and figure out exactly what I want to learn. I already know Java. I already kind of know JavaScript because I know TypeScript and I know a little bit about HTML, CSS. So I'm looking for a different language that I've never used before. And that's what I want to try to learn this year. And the last one, and I don't know how this is going to work, but I want to actually go on a vacation. So a little bit of a backstory to this on a more personal basis. Growing up, we rarely went on vacations, especially once I got older. When I was a little kid, we went on vacations more. As I got older, middle school and high school, we pretty much never went on vacations. And that really transitioned into my adult life as well, where I rarely take time off for things. I rarely go and have fun. And I was away for the Christmas, New Year's area. I was gone for a whole week. That's part of the reason that there was no content. Since I was gone, we went to various different places. We actually ended up going on what I would call kind of a mini vacation with some of my fiance's family. And it was just an overnight thing, right? But it was a really cool experience. And it reminded me that I really want to go do some kind of vacation this year, because being there, being able to recharge, not having to worry about work or anything over that time, just having fun. It's something that I've been missing, I feel like. So I want to go on one. It could be something as small as an overnight thing, but at least some kind of getaway, whether it's for a weekend, a long weekend, or a week, or whatever. And I think this might already be taken care of by the fact that I'm going to get married pretty soon this year. So because of that, we're going to go, you know, on a little vacation afterwards, but that might get covered by that. It'd be nice to do something separate from that, but if that covers it, then that's fine by me. All right, that's our goals for 2024. Let me know, folks, down in the comment section below, what are your goals for this year? And you can pick a couple, share them. They don't have to be too personal. They could be content-wise. It could be about your Minecraft world. They could be about whatever is important in your life. Feel free to share those down in the comment section below. I always love to hear your guys' goals for the year. I've been doing this now for... oh gosh, this is my 9th resolution board. Yeah, I think this is my 9th resolution board at this point. So I've been doing this for a long time. I feel like people always give great feedback and have some great goals for the year. So I love to hear them, just let me know. Anyways, folks, that's gonna wrap it up here for today. Hopefully you all enjoyed today's video. If you did enjoy today's video, make sure to leave a like. If you're new around here, feel free to subscribe to the channel for more content from this world, Afterlife, possibly build tutorials, well, at least one tutorial this year, right? And possibly other content as I make it. So, yep, I will see you all in the next video. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you later.